The movie opens with Ivan, a gorilla, whom we get to see the world through his eyes. Ivan's at a window looking at a billboard of him in a fierce pose, an advert for a circus show owned by a Mac, where he's the central attraction. Ivan reveals he's been doing this for 20 years. Ivan tells us what he does to pretend, and goes on to introduce us the characters, who keep him company in the circus, and ultimately, their roles. The opening act of the circus includes Henrietta Hitters, the baseball chicken, Frankie the seal, who's described as neurotic, Murphy the rabbit, Stella the elephant, who has long been in the circus before Ivan, and probably any other, and Snickers, the puddle dog, who has an accompanying act with Stella. We meet another dog, a stray brown mutt, who is Ivan's best buddy. His name isn't clear, but it's obvious that he often imposes on territory in which he doesn't belong. True to his word, Ivan pretends to keep the show going. He does a dramatic performance of King Kong and falls into the background again. We meet Julia, George's daughter, a worker who serves in the Big Top Mall where the circus is pitched. Julia has a fondness for Ivan, sitting close to him every time she's present. She reveals a picture of Ivan, which contrasts the ferocious beast we saw in the opening. Mac commends Julia on her drawing. George comes by and is asked about his wife, Stella. There's a bit of a mystery to this question as he answers, "She has her good day and bad days," and then evades, as it seems, Mac's question. Mac rewards Julia with money for crayons, revealing Julia's passion for drawing. After the father and daughter leave, Mac mentions how the circus has been low on earnings and might close down. Ivan and Stella are seen having a conversation while Ivan's best buddy, the dog, is resting on his belly. Ivan recollects how the dog became part of the circus and then continues by asking Stella if she remembers the glory days of the circus. Ivan further questions if Stella thinks the fallout in the circus is because Ivan lost his edge. Ivan's prepared to act the part of the angry gorilla if that would fix it, but asks why people want to see an angry gorilla. He figures that it's his responsibility to fix it because he's the headliner. At the next show, Ivan assumes his responsibilities. Afterward, Julia gifts Ivan her drawings and broken crayons, but the brown mutt questions what Ivan would do with the crayons. The mutt drifts his attention to the puddle dog, Snickers, as he's being fed. Being a stray and not accepted by Mac, the mutt wants Snickers' food. Mac spots the mutt and is upset by his appearance, specifically concerned about another mouth to feed. After Mac complains, the guard tries to get the mutt out, but Ivan scares him with his ferocious look. Cinema recap here. We've got a little challenge that'll take 5 seconds, and it will change your life forever. You ready? All you gotta do is like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell, and you'll receive 10 free years of good luck. It's as simple as that. Ivan plays around with the crayon, drawing a beetle as Mutt comes back with Snickers food. He's confused about what Ivan drew. The next morning, Mac walks into the mall to see a worker resigning due to low earnings. The camera cuts to another show, with Ivan being ferocious. After the show, the Mutt flatters Ivan, clearly bewildered by his performance, and he gets a little flustered when Ivan tells him he's acting. Julia appears and shows the Mutt a picture of himself and gives him a name, Bob. Julia notices Ivan's drawings and calls it a beetle. This creates a bond between Ivan and Julia. The next day, we see Mac's excitement as he receives a new package. Snickers tags along with Mac, while the mutt, known as Bob, uses the opportunity to eat Snickers' food. Snickers walks in on Bob and comments on him being less domesticated. She further reveals that there's no show, but a new animal. It turns out that this particular package is shy. With the help of Stella, we see the animal, a baby elephant named Rugby. She's from a circus in Jersey that has parked off. Mac tells the expectations he has in Rugby, calling her a game changer for the circus. On Rugby's first day, she finds Ivan fascinating and tries to connect, asking about his beloved stuffed toy. Although Ivan is a bit cold, Rugby persists. The show continues, but instead of Ivan being the headliner, Rugby and Stella walk out, and the crowd is ecstatic at seeing a baby gorilla. Things are looking up for the circus. Meanwhile, Rugby continues to persist with Ivan, despite the obvious resistance. The crowd is welcoming now, and the poster we once saw of Ivan as the headliner has been changed to add Rugby at the side. New sales are now coming in because of Rugby. Julia commends Rugby for her appearance, even if she doesn't do a thing. Her attention is turned to Stella's unsteady pace, and she calls her father's attention to it. Max suspects an infection and instructs that she be medicated. Stella and Rugby form a bond, with Rugby calling her Aunt Stella. Stella tells stories of herself when she was little. This scene is a loop back to when Stella was a child, stuck in a ditch. But the childlike Julia Julia came to her rescue. Bob is in doubt, displaying his internal war with humans. Rugby is fascinated about how once upon a time, animals of her kind could roam free. This longing, although not acknowledged by all, is seen in Ivan's expression. Mac's show is up, but Stella is advised to stay because she can't put any weight on her foot. Rugby is forced to ride alone instead of pairing with Stella, but the pressure is overwhelming. Despite Mac's call, she refuses to come out, but Ivan stands to inspire the shy Rugby to show up. And she does. Later, Rugby says she's hungry. Ivan improvises by drawing a carrot for her, but warns Rugby not to tell anyone. He's got a reputation to protect. Rugby accepts and demands a story, but a more genuine one, like Stella's story of her childhood. Bob starts to tell about how humans are mean, but Ivan discourages him and tells Rugby how he and Mac started up and how the show began. The flashback shows Ivan living with Mac and his wife Helen, and how Helen was frustrated at Mac's obsession with keeping Ivan because of the fascination people get. The camera cuts back to the scene where Rugby's asleep, and Stella is seen at one of her lowest moments, making Ivan promise to take care of Rugby, helping her experience freedom in a different world than the circus. These, sadly, are Stella's last words. Each teammate expressed profoundly the loss that is felt throughout the circus. Mac tries to get the circus back together by helping Rugby get her act together. Ivan inquires about Rugby, and Bob tells him that she's quite assured because she was told Ivan is gonna save her. Ivan expresses doubt at that promise, but Bob expresses confidence in him, telling him that he is the one and only Ivan, and he would figure it out. Bob and Ivan look at the sky, imagining Stella up there. The following day, Ivan is woken to the scene of Mac and Rugby practicing some trick. Mac is training her to be like Stella, yet she shows difficulties in learning. It seems she's quite unsure and doubtful of herself. Julia comments that Rugby seems tired, triggering Mac, who points out that everybody is tired. He continues the practice with Rugby until George calls out his irresponsible actions. Mac refuses to give up, insisting that he won't cancel more shows. With much push, Rugby waters Mac, revealing his toupee, and conclusively ending the practice. Later, Ivan practices his drawing, but this time with more intent. He draws a key and tells Bob about getting one from Julia, freeing Rugby, and escaping. Bob questions the plan, but Ivan is convinced they'll be able to go to the forest and be free. Charged up by his new decision, Ivan tells Rugby a story, one of hope, of them escaping. Julia examines Ivan's drawing, thrilled with his artistic progress. Mac walks in and examines the drawing, only to be inspired for another game changer, revealing once again that Ivan and the circus team are just a means to a profit for Mac. The billboard is altered to feature a less ferocious, more artistic picture of Ivan. Ivan's artistic flair turns out to be a success. It gets the press engaged, something that hasn't happened in the circus before. The circus crowd is bigger than ever because of the new act. Mac is proud, but as Ivan looks outside to see the crowd, directed by Bob, he has a sadness that we see is connected with Rugby. He's torn between running away with Rugby and performing his new successful act. Mac introduces Ivan to the crowd, describing his act as magic. But Ivan's pressure to perform lingers and, despite Mac's coaxing, he refuses to draw. He's done with being used as an object. An on-edge Mac calls out the security guard, Costello, to get Bob out or be fired himself. Later, Costello guards the circus from Bob, but he's clearly quite tired. Bob sneaks in and relates to Ivan the irony of it all, how you can be protected and used by the humans at the same time. Ivan reveals his escape plans to Bob, pleading for him to get focused so the plan can work out. Because Costello is focused on getting him, Bob is the bait, even though he doesn't like it. Bob bites Costello in the butt, leading him to Ivan's cell and tricking him into opening the door. Thinking Ivan's asleep, Costello walks into the cell, preparing to catch Bob. But Ivan's trick works, and Costello ends up fainting from shock. Having successfully tricked the guard, Ivan locks him inside the cell and is joined by Rugby, revealing that they're breaking out. Rugby inquires about the other team members. All the team members walk together as instructed by Ivan. Bob calls out to Snickers, appealing to her to leave with him. But Snickers is too sophisticated. She sees no place for her in the wild. Faced with a closed door, the animals face the difficult decision of what's next. Knowing no other way to go, Ivan breaks the door open, setting off an alarm. Bob, who claims to know the streets, leads the animals on their path to freedom. A call is made to Ivy, and the group are forced to hide as Mac's car passes. They decide to cross the street, which becomes a perilous adventure as Murphy, the rabbit, is almost crushed to death. A man notices them cross, although comes to believe it's nothing more than a hallucination. Max speeds to the mall, alerted by the alarms. To his horror, he discovers that not only have the animals escaped, but Costello is trapped inside the exhibit. Outside, Mac looks to the road, noticing the expanse of forest opposite the mall. The group is clearly excited to be in the wild, experiencing things they haven't before. Soon, however, they come to realize that there's nothing beyond the trees except a city, civilization, more humans. Asserting Ivan as a leader, they ask, what's next? But before they can figure it out, Mac arrives. Ivan tries to be defensive, but Mac explains that it's not safe for the animals to be out near the city. He's trying to protect them. Later, George arrives to find a tired Mac, who reveals Costello has been fired. Mac is concerned about letting the city find out about the animals' breakout, holding George to a pack. If the news gets out, they'll be shut down. As Mac and George leave, Rugby inquires about the wild, but Ivan's defensive, telling her that he doesn't recall much about it. Bob insists that he doesn't want to remember. Ivan tries to recall the details, telling the story of how he came to be the gorilla that he is. Initially, he was known as Mud because he was drawing with mud. Flashbacks are shown, revealing that he does have a family and a sister. They were captured by men and separated from their family after his father got shot. Ivan reveals his guilt and why he has kept the stuffed toy of money. Bob reinforces the fact that humans are evil, that cockroaches have bigger hearts. Yet Rugby reminds them of Stella. The group is back at their regular routine, even Rugby. Julia comes to see Ivan, bringing him cans of paint and telling him that she's heard about the breakout incident. Julia compares Ivan's captivity with her mom's hospitalization, expressing her sadness about people being stuck in cages. She reveals that she draws to find a sort of stability to her world. Julia promises Ivan if he drew enough, it might come true. At the pool, Ivan remembers how it felt to draw in the mud. He has an idea and uses Julia's paints to draw on the wall with a painted canvas. The next day, Mac is excited for yet another great play day. A reporter arrives, revealing that she heard about the escape from the guy in the car. But Mac denies any such incident and attempts to continue with the show. As usual, the routine is followed, with Rugby replacing Stella. But instead of a performance, everyone, even Mac, is awed by Ivan's colorful, stunning depiction of a forest. Only Julia can see Ivan's heart, that he's painting the world as he wants it to be. She convinces her father to help set Ivan free. He resists, but she secures the help of the local reporter. The reporter helps Julia set up a campaign throughout the city, seeking freedom for Ivan and Rugby. Rugby's confused, but Bob and Ivan see the opportunity for freedom. Mac, meanwhile, struggles with the decision, weighing the circus with the animal's well-being. We see the final decision as Rugby is set free and bonds with Ivan, going back to meet other elephants. With Ivan's support, Rugby takes a leap of faith and ventures into the unknown of the wild. Mac is left with Snickers, Bob, and Ivan, as Bob finally accepts his name. Unconsciously, this series of events has led him to consider that the domestic option is probably the best for him. Before Ivan leaves, Mac comes over to remember the glory days. Finally, Ivan takes his leaps of faith and walks into a world of his own, freedom. This movie's a recap of The One and Only Ivan, produced by Disney. It's an adaptation of the book by K.A. Applegate, starring Bryan Cranston as Mac and voiceovers by Angelina Jolie as Stella and Sam Rockwell as Ivan. If you were Ivan, would you want to be free or remain in captivity? Tell us in the comments below with the hashtag CinemaRecap.